Hi Pisces, thank you so much for tuning in. Welcome. We are going to perform a reading for the month you are in now. But this may also show up in different times in your life. You are at Tarot Solar Sun Studio and I am Caro. I'm going to now perform who is destined to be on your path. And we will start to talk about this concept as our reading progresses. First, when this person arrives to your life, let's see how is your life. I mean, so what they gonna find when they are actually showing up in your path? Let's see first you. Oops, not yet, too much. Okay, so King of Pentacles, Three of Pentacles, and we have a Ten of Wands. Okay, so when this person comes, and let's check out their astrological energy. I'm going to reveal them as energy, not necessarily signs. These three cards solely represent you and no one else. So each of the cards here is you. First, we are going to look at you when they are now showing up on your path. Now, King of Pentacles energy, we have who is the business king and who keeps the garden green, right? Here we have also, it's interesting. It's like, I'm by the way using the Alice in Wonderland deck. That's why you can quite see the narratives here, so it feels good. You are here working so hard. Yes, they are actually coming in a very busy timeline. You are working so hard that for instance, you learn from others, but also you teach others. You take the directions, but you also give directions. I see you here. Okay, so this person actually... Oh, Katina's there. This person actually trying to intervene. I mean, they see you like being so busy, I do feel. Maybe at the time you come, they come, you are here like collaborating with someone, and it's like something becomes a bit like a burden, like you got to do it like by yourself. So it's like they see you for that quality of hardworking. They see you like sometimes maybe it's hard to delegate to other people, but you take it all on yourself. Like you got to do everything like on yourself, for yourself. So they see actually you are maybe working alone, or you have this business, you are try to delegate, or you take other delegations from others, but it's, you are really being so busy. They are going to display a Scorpio Capricorn energy. Okay, so you are finding a Scorpio Capricorn. Okay. Maybe we can. This can be our inner joke with you. So Capricorn. Okay, Scorp and Capricorn. Scorp. I'm like butchering Scorp and Capricorn person. So this person somehow now is going to engage with you. This person is destined to be on your path, and as I see here, the Pentacles and the Ten of Wands influence in your energy. How to say, there is definitely some type of a heavy material life, mundane life considerations there. So they are directly, you know, intervening in from that daily concerns, okay? Not at a time of like fun, not at a time of like, for instance, you go to a pub or a bar, you meet with this person. No, it's not like that. So there is a kind of a on a daily engagements here. Yes, and we have the second house energy. Now this is a place where it actually shows your talents and also how you earn money, your talents, your health, the things that you value in your life, what you value, and also what you want, of course. And it's usually a Taurus house, so it's actually, you know, by nature, it can be a place where we are patient with. So I do feel, for, you know, some reason, this person is super patient with you. They are super patient with you. There is a here something with people's personal finances and material possessions as well. Maybe there is going to be some sort of a together investment or a discussion around the terms of concepts of values. You find something to be important and you wanna take actions towards that. This person finds this and this important and they wanna take actions for that. Maybe there is, again, a lot of financial prospects and how we do also our work around it. So there is something in the nature of how we actually rule also things when it comes to material possession. So there is some type of an interaction taking place there. It's actually a very grounded and practical energy. It's very down to earth energy. So, Scorpio is also about other people's money and resources. So that there can be something like, for instance, the connection. They take something from you, they convert and transform it, Scorpio, and then Capricorn. Then they put it into the some kind of a top place, or like try to work it out and make it like more structural, or Capricorn, like trying to make it organized. Okay, so, but this is some kind of interaction where, let me see the planetary energy, by the way. Don't forget, our question is, who is destined to be on your path, okay? Okay, now, one of you will be may have some actually, this can be, you know, one of you can be a very creative person, and there is some kind of a straightforward energy in this relationship. Like someone is very much expressive about how they really feel about things. We do this, but I am feeling this about that. There is also some type of, you know, something artistic with the moon energy. And you know, this person, your connection is something like that. This person knows on what to spend, like their money, what they want to, what to put their also their money on. So and they need to, in order for them to feel emotionally secure, the moon in the second house, they need to be certain with regards to their financial future, if this is like stable as well. Okay, so that's why maybe there is some kind of a stability here. Look, the emotional connections really differ based on our moon signs. Actually, they emotionally connect. The emotional connection here is through the person's stability and security. And here, at this time, it's about if they have also, they are also very oriented in that way. Actually, very generous, objective, and resourceful person. Sometimes can feel though very detached as well. The Scorpio energy can give a bit stubbornness. Sometimes they can really hide their emotions or their discomfort. So you need to be curious to ask questions to them if you want them to also, you know, open up a bit. You need to be curious about asking how they are feeling, rather than guessing or assuming what they are. Okay, so curious conversations will be very important. So they actually like the stability of life you try to form somehow in you. Okay, by the way, this person have a great capacity to spend a lot of money on making gifts for you or to you. It will be normal for them sometimes. Actually, they put other people's needs above their own. But this is not necessarily the healthiest thing to do, of course. That's why make sure, you know, that their needs also are met, because they will be thinking about yours a lot. Again, the emotional safety there and happiness with you is strongly related how you gonna set your future, okay, together. They may value also high quality possessions, comfort, you know, security. They are in the Taurus house in the end. They can like, by the way, I don't know, but I feel there is a sense of an antique shop that deal with valuable things here, or something with regards to real estates. They can be also good at. So they somehow actually manage these finances. They are definitely pretty much evolved when it comes to nourishing their love for beauty, you know, or art. They can get their hands into expensive things, and they can, for instance, sell them in better prices. Scorpio energy, these, they are all Scorpio energy. And making something like go structured and organizational is Capricorn. So you see, once you notice that dynamic, this is actually their natural ability. And when we understand people's natural abilities, and when we connect through these things, you know, it's like, again, you are a fish, let's say, and you are. We can't expect you to go and, you know, climb up a mountain, right? So there needs to be a good understanding of each other's talents and skills and how they can also use this resourcefully in a relationship. Again, that Scorpio energy will demand that, by the way. Scorpio energy likes to say, you know, our money, or, you know, to see something like, because it's that V energy, which is opposite of Taurus, I, mine energy. So that security craving, of course, may make them to crave money due to sometimes lack of security, because actually the money energy there is about for them to buy their security deep down, because that's the moon. Emotionally, they are doing fine in that way. Okay, so there is this sense. Now, let's see the path, which is likely. Okay, we see the characteristics. We see you now from the Lover's Path Tarot, which is the perfect deck, I think, for this reading. Let's see your path together. Ten of Cups. Eight of Coins. Oh, you work hard with this person. Creating future together. Wow. Wow, wow, wow. Venus, balance. This is the Temperance card. Seeking balance in different also compartments of life will be very important, actually, because there is also some type of a celebration there. This is the Art of Life. I will come back to your cards. Art of Life deck. First time I'm using, I think. There are some beautiful quotes. Now, let's see some quality time in our reading. Spending quality time with my quarants in their readings. Okay, this is like with my quarants reading is a quality time, of course. But to have like an extra quality time with them in a reading is like a good one. We have the Hangman. When I let go of what I am, I become what I might be. Oh, this is actually evoking each other's talents. Maybe one person is going to feel so much expectation, and they got to do the best and this and that, which may lead to some type of a burnout. So maybe your energy as the Piscean quality, you may, Scorpio Capricorn actually is a good match to you, because they will definitely need your, with this fixed cardinal, your mutual capacity. It's like you may tell them, look, you are getting so much fixed in that particular thing. Actually, if you do not hold your breath, you can simply inhale and exhale, right? If they are not letting go, for instance, if we cannot let go of our breath, we can't breath. Yes, we inhale, but right, we have to let go of the breath so we can inhale. It's actually is pretty much the same thing. Like you say you are holding on to your breath so much, let go sometimes, you can inhale and exhale so that you can be that, right, a living being. How a breath is important. Again, when I let go of what I am, I become what I might be, allowing space also for oneself to see their potential. And you know, you see how actually two people here, I think they are already in each other, but you see the flexibility there. Beautiful image. Two acrobats, Ernst Kinshash, Kinshare Museum, Davos, Switzerland. I have never gone to Switzerland, ladies and gentlemen, but if you go before me, definitely visit that. I would love to visit Switzerland, definitely one day. I hope I can make a good, you know, I have this dream actually. Three important tarot countries is Italy, France, and Spain. Because tarot has, you know, influenced, come from the direction of also the Northern Africa, from the Mamluks, you know. So those countries at the edge of the Mediterranean has influence. So, and there are many tarot museums there, especially in Italy, by the way. There was one master who was crafting handmade decks in Milano. But unfortunately, he passed away a couple of years ago. This is one of my biggest worry, you know. I couldn't see him, and, you know, sometimes there is this... we have this item saying, you know, one person taking a hand from a person, giving a hand to a person, taking a hand from a person. Like, they touch you, and somehow, of course, you don't suddenly feel with their skills or something. This is not about that. But it's like that interaction, like they give you like an access. It's like an initiation, yes. So... I would go and take hand from him before I started to actually create my own deck. But unfortunately, he has passed away. So yeah, when I go to that countries, I would love to visit their tarot museums. And in Spain, there is also one. It's very big. Also in some cities in Italy, it's so rich with the tarot tradition. And of course, France is also, you know, Paris is an occult city in the end. And the thing that I want, when I go to a place, I would love to shoot a video for you to maybe starting another channel, you know, some tarot stories, you know. This is one of my actually plans, but of course we need some good finance for it, for that type of a trip, and anything around tarot, of course, it fascinates me. I would love to take you with me there, and hope we will be making it. I hope so. How flexible energy is that? This when I let go of what I am, I become what I might be. This is this is Lao Tzu's, and again, the Taoist perspective always in the end comes and makes that last remark. That it's just like incredible, really. It's incredible. I think. Okay, so Temperance, Ten of Cups, Eight of Pentacles, and Temperance card. This is Venus and Vulcan. So, okay, actually, this is pretty much mythological, you know. Venus is actually a goddess, Greek goddesses. It's a mythology character and the goddess, but she was actually first worshipped as a nature goddess, this arrival of spring, you know, and later gaining this fame for that sensual exploits. This is actually to balance her natural exuberance, and that's why the gods has wed her with Vulcan, and this is the god of the forge. First, Venus actually did not appreciate her husband's skillful craftsmanship, and And she actually shared her affections with others. But despite this, their marriage endured. Okay? So they were so opposite. That's why it says this one about balance. It's about self-control, harmony, equilibrium, artistry, and also integration, that balance. And in Hangman, there is also actually sort of balance. Like, you balance something by letting go of another thing. Like, it both, you know, unites the conscious and the unconscious of aspects of the psyche. So your lesson with this person is to find balance. The thing is, now in the Venus and Vulcan story, I don't know if one of you, like, let's say, will have still some affections outside of this connection. Maybe it's gonna take time for them to, like, maybe fully commit to a relationship. But there is a really a field there. Okay, there is definitely a field there, and it is promising. Why don't we get also the Power of Love deck? Interesting. Oh my God, I am using some decks really first time, and I'm very happy to use them. I'm gonna bring my treasures out for you. Kindness is being taught here. You are a humanitarian made of love, and you are able to share that energy with others. So kindness is a lesson. Sharing is a lesson. Is there any challenging lessons apart from that that is going to sharpen our senses? That I am learning that endings are merely beginnings. This is about letting go. Actually, it's pretty much the Hangman. That here is like not actual death, of course, but it is a transformation where you just that old skin, shedding skin, like letting go of what I am, like this ego attachment or fixating oneself to a particular identification. I think identification and identifications we make are very important and healthy when it comes to a healthy ego, you know, building up. But when overly attaching something or overly identifying with something, you know, when that thing goes or it breaks, then it brings the greatest handicaps, right? That's why, you know, if you are a person who thinks that there is actually a self beyond your beyond you, there is actually that, you know, Jung called this with the capital S, self, that higher self, you can entertain that concept, that little attachments, identifications, you can entertain them, but not overly attached to them, knowing that you are actually a soul greater than that. Like, there is that actually that inner self, inner world. But the identifications are necessary, I think. So this is, yeah, I think when people meet here with this pet person, maybe one of you or you are both feeling overly identifying with something. So each other here is, I think, helping one another to shed some skin on that, showing that with the Piscean influence, with the Piscean energy, there is always a some kind of a, you know, transcendental understanding of how things work, interconnected, mysticism, you know, magical, all encompassing. Maybe that's your part, to take away that over identification, but with regards to this person, but not doing it in, of course, a forceful way. It's like just, it's an effortless thing happening by itself, by time. still like, well, it's not quite good. I like this reading. I like this reading. Very much, this Pentacle energy is super strong. So Pentacle domain, Earth domain is definitely super strong. And I think Eight of Pentacles, Temperance, and Ten of Cups, this is about really trying to secure and balance life through financial security, but also some effort needs to be put out there in order to reach that balance, because you need first the tips of the scales. So in order to create that scales, you need to forge it. This is actually like Vulcan. You need to forge it, right? This is not crafted in a hot iron, but of course they are metal. They have sewn that iron thing. So, by the way, one person can be really good at maybe with these tools. Yeah, in order to balance, you will eventually need the scales. So, with the scales, that needs to be the parts coming from both of you. So in the relationship, maybe you are going to find balance. Also, you know, while working hard towards the goals, but also trying to achieve some kind of an inner peace, blending the opposites. You are likely to, and Ten of Cups, you have an emotional also motivation to do so together, because something fulfills you there. There is a lot of patience and determination here. And one knows, of course, it requires a lot of patience and determination to manifest the fruits of one's work. This is what is needed. There is no right away results, right? It's you need each other committed in this and dedicated in this, so that you can achieve the desired results there. Ten of Cups also, it's about people's, I think, in the relationship, that positive outlook. Though I see this person's cravings of material resources, money, and things, but they need it for the emotional stability. This is, it's not about, actually, the emotional stability, we usually understand it very one-sided. But actually, every person's, if you can understand the person's moon sign, if you can really understand a person's moon sign, you can really have at least, you know, least turbulent connection with them. It's very important. When you understand a person's moon sign and the aspects it's making it in their natal chart, you actually basically understand them, really. And in the connection, it's very crucial to maintain this equilibrium and inner peace, practicing patience, trust, kindness to oneself and to each other will be very important. Your relationship is like the epitome of, actually it's highlighting the importance of balance and dedication in relationships. And also to have some kind of a faith, Ten of Cups, this is also a Piscean card. You have this faith in the process. Between work and personal life, there can be some maybe sacrifices there. But at some point, I think everything will fall into its place with patience and persistence. It's very essential to stay grounded, optimistic, okay? And this is what I can tell. I think this reading, it's really perfect in its own way. Thank you very much for tuning in. I hope you enjoy your reading. I think who is destined to be in my path is a very good question. It came to me instantly. And when I find these good questions, I will come with these stamps. You know, my readings are usually thematic. It's a good question. This one, we got it well. So, yeah, thank you so much, Pisces. It was nice to also chatting to you through this our quality time of the reading. Take good care, and I will see you in the next readings. By the way, if you didn't make your recommendation to name my new friends and our also new mascot in the channel, there is a video I will deliver them there, and you can click and make your recommendations in the comment section. I'm trying to find a name for this new baby, okay? Thank you so much. Take good care. Bye-bye.